Hold on a second. Let me get this straight. This ref has what kind of paste on him? Toothpaste?
It's a paste made from what are called Uchigamori stones and sodium bicarbonate. And it's used to polish samurai swords in an ancient Japanese ritual.
Okay, but according to the coroner's report, Shimada was beaten and strangled. He wasn't stabbed with a samurai sword.
No, he wasn't. But I'm thinking, what if the blade on the sword was dull and the perp used it to beat Shimada? It'd practically be the same thing as working him over with a jagged metal pipe.
Maybe so. But until I see that katana, it's still not enough to go on.
Well, then let's hope it's still at the arena.
By the way, Horace Willingham, the league's owner, called a couple of minutes ago. He's waiting for you in his office.
Fellas, how's it going? What can I do for you? I never miss a fight if I can help it. About midnight, got a call from Tina Allens. She works for me. You talked to her yet?
Yeah, she sent us your way, actually.
Yeah, well, she called me, said she'd found Rick. I told her to hang tight, I'd get back as soon as I could. And here I am. Well, let me think on that for a second. I started this league about 4 years ago. I kind of poached Rick from another league, tell you the truth, and I'd say that wasn't more than 6 months after we got on our feet around here. Oh, hell no. I was a fighter. Oh yeah, 10 years. I was one tough son of a bitch, I kid you not. I'm like that fella Evel Knievel. I must have broken every bone in my body at one time or another. I'd still be doing it, too. Seriously. My former employers had to come to me on bended knee and beg me to retire. Offered me a pretty hefty severance package, truth be told. So, my last fight, man, what a night. That was the night of March 12th, 1999. Rick was the referee. It's funny, it was my last night and his first. We became fast friends. And so, when I took that money they gave me to quit and then I decided to start this league, well hell, of course I was gonna bring my boy Rick over here with me. Hank and I go back about 2 years. Funny story, actually. I offered him a contract the very same night I witnessed the man take down 3 bouncers in a barroom brawl. Man, that boy can fight. Tough as nails. No disrespect to anyone else on my roster, but Hank's the very best there is. First rule of Supreme Force fighting, you do not fight outside the ring. Second rule of Supreme Force fighting, you do not fight outside the ring. When I say we train them, what I really mean is we discipline them. Hone and polish their skills, try to instill a sense of honor in them. Excuse me for asking, but why are you asking all these questions about Hank? Is he a suspect or something?
Just being thorough.
And let me check here. Problem with taking one too many whacks to the head is that you kind of develop this nasty habit of putting stuff somewhere for safekeeping and then spending the next hour trying to remember where you put the damn thing. Okay, good. Here it is. I guess my mind isn't as dull as I thought.
Does anyone else have a copy of this key?
No. Just me. Hey, I don't mean to step out of line here or nothing, but I gotta ask a favor of you. Is there any way to keep this thing kinda quiet? I mean, do you think we can keep this out of the press for a little while? It's just that I've lost a couple of things in my life that were pretty dear to me. My first wife, Grace, I lost to cancer. God rest her soul. And then, well, I lost my ability to fight. And now, the thought of losing this league because of all of this, well, it's just a little more than I can truly bear.
Mr. Willingham, it's department policy not to discuss ongoing investigations.
All right, good. We got an image to maintain.
Nice find. A beautiful copy of Willingham's fingerprint. You are good. Tina left her lipstick. A minor tragedy for those of us who appreciate artificially colored lips. It's a two-way street. The lipstick goes on her lips, and her DNA goes on the lipstick. Now we've got Tina's prints for our file. He works. Let's head upstairs. Pretty nice setup here. Looks like it's capable of recording whatever's happening in the fighting ring from 1, 2, 5 different angles. That VCR isn't connected to the mixing board. Looks like it's wired directly to the security camera. Video cassette. Remember when I said this is a pretty nice setup? I take it back. This must be the prop closet. Well, there's only one prop we need. Whoa. Just came apart in your hands. I'm gonna guess it didn't do that during the show last night. I wouldn't worry about cutting yourself. Blade's too dull. It looks as though there was a piece of wood that held the blade in. Somehow it broke. Well, what do you know? Initials H. Well, it doesn't quite spell it out for us, but I think it's a pretty good bet this sword belongs to Hank Hackett, unless Hugh Hefner is even better with the sword than we realized. See that? It's some kind of oily residue, and it's all over the blade. And we have blood on the blade of the sword. I wonder whose it is. Blood on the sword is a match to Rick Shimada. Probably broke during the attack, then the killer used the microphone cord to finish the job. Dimethoxymethane. I've actually seen it before. It's an acid-based hydrocarbon, pretty common in metal cleaners. Perfect for removing fingerprints and other trace evidence from a metal surface.